If you're using other Linux distributions like Red Hat, CentOS, Fedora, when you install those distributions, even Kali Linux, you can install server version or desktop version, and you can install both server and desktop version in graphical user interface mode. But in Ubuntu, when you install Ubuntu server, it does not include graphical user interface, and the reason is obvious, because server is optimized to handle specific services and designed to run server-oriented tasks by careful allocation of resources. But if you want to install GUI in your Ubuntu server for some reason, maybe you find some application easy to manage using GUI, you can easily add desktop environment in your server. Since Ubuntu 20.04, it uses same kernel for both desktop environment and server version. So that means you can use same packages in both versions interchangeably, and you can easily switch from desktop version to server and vice versa if you need to consider the resources. But just keep in mind that desktop environment consumes more resources than text-based server version. And if you want to take advantage of desktop environment but want to use minimal resources, you can use some of the lightweight display managers like Slim or LightDM. The default display manager for Ubuntu is GDM3, which uses more resources. It's more resource intensive display manager than other lightweight managers that I just mentioned. And if resource is not an issue for you, I would recommend you getting a GDM3. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to install graphical mode in your Ubuntu server by using GDM3 as a display manager, and we'll use Ubuntu default desktop environment, which is Gnome. So let's get our repository up to date first. In Ubuntu, you can use sudo apt-get update to update your repository, and we can run another command after that is done using ampersand sign, and upgrade command will actually upgrade your system, and hyphen y will answer yes if it will ask you yes and no questions. So asking you for my password. And after our repository is up to date, we are going to install the task cell utility, which allows us to install the related package automatically using text user interface, and comes very handy when we install display manager and desktop environment later. So let's do that. Sudo, clear the screen. Sudo apt get install task cell. Yes. So this is where upgrade hyphen y answer yes for me. And it's done. So next step would be installing a display manager, which takes care of loading desktop environment and also authenticate users in GUI environment. And we're going to install the default display manager, which is GDM3. But if you want to install lighter version, you can use a Slim or LightDM. apt get install Slim or LightDM and hit enter. In our case, I'm going to do GDM3. Yes. And our next step would be actually installing the desktop environment. So we updated our repository, upgraded our system for latest packages, then installed task cell to select the tasks that we're going to install later, and just installing display manager, GDM3. And after this is done, we are going to install default desktop for Ubuntu, which is Gnome desktop. A lot of packages and libraries and dependencies to be installed. And this is why you have to be careful when you install GUI in your server, because it can take a lot of resources and your server might be overloaded, or it might take away some resources that you can allocate to some other services otherwise. So it's good to learn, but I'm not sure if it's a good idea to have your server running with the desktop environment all the time. Because when you are remoting into your server, usually using SSH, you will not get the graphical mode, even if you have graphical mode installed in your servers. In my case, this Ubuntu is installed in VirtualBox along with other machines, but I have installed latest Ubuntu on my laptop, which is dual boot system with Windows 10. And I have started using Ubuntu desktop primarily. Looks like that is finished. So now let's install the Gnome desktop. And for that, we just have to run the task cell from command line. Do sudo task cell. So now it's giving us the text-based interface to select the packages we need. You can use up and down arrow key to move your selection. And when you reach to the package that you want to install, just hit the spacebar. The asterisk will be displayed, and then hit tab to go to the OK button and just install. So you see on the list, you have a lot of other options. Minimal desktop, Ubuntu Mate desktop, that's also another desktop environment. And we're going to install Ubuntu desktop, so click OK. So a lot of packages. So let's fast forward. Okay, we're almost there, 95% done. So it's done. So let's go ahead and start the service. Service DBM3 start. I see the mouse here. So this is without reboot. There you go. Privacy now done. So this is it. This is how you can install or convert your text-based user Ubuntu server into graphical user interface desktop. We have a home file manager, and then you have a trash and all that. And then you can access terminal from here. And if you want, you can add it to the favorite, right click and click on favorite. So it'll stay on this left side. And I usually like to turn off the bell so it doesn't give me the annoying bell sound when there's a problem with the command or. And my favorite is gray on black. Scrolling, I usually turn off. And that's it. You can actually hit F11 to go to the full screen mode. F11, come back in. And then let me restart because my display setting is not optimized. So resolution. Okay, let me try this one. Much better. So it looks like I didn't have to restart. Here you can change background, appearance, how you want to do notifications. So you can customize your desktop in many ways. So let me restart the server. I just want to make sure that graphical mode comes up by default. Okay, as you saw, graphical mode came up as a default, and you can use software update here to install any new software or update your softwares using graphical user interface mode. You don't have to run apt get commands. It's fine. And one thing you'll notice on Ubuntu is, let me run this update first and I'll show you. So Ubuntu has started installing Snap as a part of packages. So Snap is a bundle of packages which has all the dependencies and libraries bundled together, so you don't have to worry about the dependencies and library. So Ubuntu software installer by default launches and install Snaps. But if you want to install in traditional way, you can always do apt get install command. The only problem with the Snap is the space. I'll create a separate video talking about how to clean up your Ubuntu machine, desktop or server especially if you're running into desktop environment. I just talked about space and then it gave me this error. So I have option to examine, restart later. So it's giving me how this space is being used. Okay, so it gave me pretty, so it could be my snap and maybe the cast also. So do you have well 760 MB, and it could be the journal log. I have 36 MB, not that much. How about snaps? Sudo. Snapd and snaps. So 314 MB. It'll start building once you start using more and more. So this video is just about how to install graphical user interface or desktop environment in your Ubuntu server, which does not have a graphical user interface. And since you already saw that as soon as I install and ran graphical user interface, my system gave me the error message that I'm running out of space. So in my next video, I'm gonna create at least few steps that you can take to clean up your Ubuntu server or desktop environment. So this is it for this video. Just wanted to show you how to convert your text-based Ubuntu server into a graphical mode and use like a Windows computer. So if you're liking my videos or the format that I'm creating since last few weeks, let me know in the comment box. And if there's any topic that you think I should cover in the server, networking, cybersecurity, firewall, and cryptography, you can tell me in the comment box and I'll try to cover as much as I can. Until then, take care and thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.